Good evening. Tonight we are making a Tex-Mex beef and rice casserole in the Dutch oven.
For this one, I'm going to use the 12-inch Dutch oven.
There's
what they look like.
Catfish got nice crust. All right, so first things first, I'm gonna grease the oven real fast. Help keep things from sticking to it. And can't open her. And we're going to, I've got one can chicken broth. Set that in there. Cover that up, and I need 2 cups of rice. More potato chip cans make good rice, spaghetti, macaroni. They do good for a lot of your dry goods. And we're just gonna let that soak for a few minutes while we get the rest of our dinner going. Really wish I had some better coals than that, but I think that might work okay. Thank you. go with that. Heat up a few minutes, and then we're just gonna fry our hamburger and onion on top of the lid. That should be hot enough. Would have liked a little bit bigger coals, but I think that'll be worth. I think that'll work okay for the hamburger. There's a sacrifice piece. There we go. Okay, so we'll season that a little bit. I'm going to use probably a little salt and pepper, of course. Maybe some garlic and some onion. Maybe a tiny bit of cumin. And then we'll just let that go at that. So what we're going to do is we're going to cook this about halfway, and then we're going to add some the onion that we chopped up earlier to it. Cook that the rest of the way, dump it all in the pot with the rice, and then let it cook out from there. I've got a mess going on over here, so here's what I'm going to do. I've got to drain some of this grease off. Yeah, it's not working out as good as I would have liked, but good enough, I suppose. Yeah, we should add the onions now, I think. Go get the onions. I'll be right back. Just let these fry up too. With the rest of the meat. I brought my seasonings out here, so we'll get all that going at the same time. Oop, another sacrifice. little ground pepper. Woo! Little much ground pepper. Hopefully not as fast, but a little cumin. A little cumin goes a long way, so. And a little onion. Well, a little caked up onion. For camp purposes, I do not buy the expensive seasoning. Store brand works out good. It draws moisture, it cakes up, anyhow. For the environment it has to sit in, store brand seasonings will work just fine. Alright, so the burger is about done. I need to make a quick little sauce for everything. And I've got some cream cheese. I don't know where that came from. So here, softening up. I used a whole 8 ounces of it, the little brick dude, if I can get it open. Like I said, if I can get it open. There we go. Got it open that time. Well, half-ass. This little fellow does not want to open, let me tell you. All right, there we go. Now it's opened. So I got a full eight ounces of cream cheese. That was difficult. And need 2 tablespoons of milk. Where's my table? Go with that. There we go. 2 tablespoons of milk. And where'd you go? One package of taco seasoning. And we will just mix that all together. Sauce out of that. Sorta. Cream cheese is not wanting to blend very good there. Good enough for there. And where'd I go? I lost a couple of nuts. Another ingredient. Because I do not have a can opener out, and I've got to open up some cans. So it also gets a can of Mexican corn, and I've got a can of fire roasted tomatoes, and then a can of basically Rotel, but this is a store brand. So we'll get those opened up and then put in here, and then get back with you. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. The burger is definitely done. The coals are about spent too. So we are going to gently transfer our meat and onions to our rice here. Breaking that piece up a little bit. All right. And we're just gonna lay this on top of the rice. So we'll go back and get our sauce, pour it over top of there, then it gets some shredded cheese, cilantro, and some crunched up corn chips, and then we'll let that bake for a while and then add some more cheese. So there's our sauce, which just made up a few minutes ago with the fire roasted tomatoes, the rotel, the just lay that pretty close to that. Ideally, the cream cheese should have been broken up a little bit better, but it will be okay. I do believe that is as much as I'm going to get out of there, so rip that again. Cilantro. Put that in there. And I love cilantro. Alright. I've got some shredded Mexican blend cheese. That over there, like yay. Like that. Save that for the end. Tortilla chips. There we go. Just like that. Alright, so what I'm going to do is get that out of there. Is replenish my coals and put a layer of coals down underneath, not as thick. And then we'll put some more coals on top and then we'll bake it for about half an hour. And add some more cheese to it. And then come back. That's about as much coal as I'm going to get out of that. I really would like to have a few more. But gotta work with what you got. Okay, so I'm going to try to get my fire built up a little bit more. Hopefully get a few more coals out of that so I can add some more to the top. So it's been 35 minutes, and let's see how we're looking here. I did just a second ago spin everything around, so let's see how we're doing. I'm about ready to add some more cheese if it is ready. Ooh, that's looking pretty nice. Yeah, see, look at that. We'll add some more cheese on top and replenish these coals. And then that'll go another 15 minutes or so. All right, so it's been 10 minutes or so since I put more cheese on it. See how we did here. I am being told to hurry up though, so I know it's pretty much done. It's just really the cheese that I'm working on. But let's see how it looks. Oh, that looks really good. That's starting to get some toasty lookings right in there. Tell you what, I'm gonna put that right there because that seems to be where the hot spot is. Let that toast up another 5 minutes, and then I'm going to pull it right there, and we'll call it dinner. It's really about the aesthetics, but It'll be a full hour at that point. And we'll be eating real soon. There you go. Cool.
Yeah. Isn't that pretty?
All right, Ruthie, get you something to eat.
Fluffed up quite a bit, didn't it?
I don't know if I remember this or not.
Pretty sure there'll be a leftover out of that. So let's see how it, there we go.
Good blend of flavors.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's really good. It's cooked all the way through. Hot.
Not as spicy as I would have called for, but it's a very, very good blended, neutral. I don't know how to explain it well, but it, I think, and next time I would do a, instead of a mild red tail type, I would have went for the probably more red clover. Might as well.